1.
I said I'm ready for greatness. I said I'm ready for greatness. I said I'm ready for greatness. I said I'm ready for greatness.
It's boning biggie biggie. 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 It's boning biggie biggie.
Yo, yo, what is, what to do, my name is Elijah Mike, we're back on the mic, we're back for another session, another gaming session, another quiet place, part 6.
Hi, how are you?
Yes, so we're back, bro. The last time we ended on day 1, and we figured out why our mother-in-law hates us.
God damn.
Doesn't make quite sense. Not really, because we tried to shoot, the husband got up, and it was actually your son's fault.
Shoot him, shoot him, shoot him.
Jesus Christ. So don't blame me. Don't blame me.
Okay.
But yeah, man, we figured out why our mother-in-law hates us. Because her husband was killed by these things. And she blames me.
No. Oh no! No. So that's how your husband died. Damn, you can't be mad at me. I tried. I literally tried. Your son is the reason.
Oh, that's crazy. So you hate us because of that? Well, it's not our fault. It's the son's fault. The son should have never coughed. Should have never got us pregnant either.
What?
But hey, we're here. You know, we're back from that session. So let's get it. Right, day 120, man. Day 120. We're back. Down the little thing, right? I think so, right? Yeah. Okay. Little headache. It's okay. Got a little headache. Jesus. Got a broken flashlight now. New diary entry. I must have blacked out that day. That the day everything began, was it my fault? Would we have lost Robert anyway? Yeah, we would have lost him, bro. It was no way, because it was really the son's fault. For months, I've tried to tell myself it was inevitable, but still, the guilt never fades. I can't turn back time. I can't change what happened. I can't even look ahead. It's too damn dark. It's not her fault, though. The crazy thing is, it's not her fault. It's not her fault at all. I was able to get the lights working again, but I'll be honest, I don't know how long they're going to last, since we can't actually swap out wiring. Keep a couple of flares on you in case things go dark again. If you run out of flares, grab the dynamo flashlight, but let's only use that in emergencies. Okay. Yup.
You're not gonna get very far without any light. I should look for another light source.
You know how long it's been since Pat left? I stopped counting, stopped caring. All that is left is me in the waste, nothing to do but sit here and watch it get purged. Too many to make way for something clean up here. And it got me thinking, what if that's all this is? What if we're the waste and it's time for us to be purged? Is that really such a bad thing? It could make a way for something better. Maybe the world didn't end after all. Maybe it's just our world that ended. Our world.
What?
Bruh.
Nice.
this nigga didn't just turn around. Like, bro, you were supposed to jump over this. Why did you turn? That's that bullshit I'm talking about.
Jesus.
Fuck. I'm okay.
What the hell?
I see Xamarin the messages on one set in blue ink, the other in red. Devin even seeing this ish. But the mom says, yes, nuts. You think anyone survived? I mean, we're alive, right? Gotta be others out there. My parents, they gotta be all right. Your phone gotten any reception? No. Yeah, same. But do we? Pat? I mean, if there are other survivors out there, they're gonna need clean water, don't you think? I guess. Well, it's not gonna stay clean for long if something happens to this place, so I said we do it. Do what? Keep the place going. I don't know what the hell else we can do, but if we keep this station running, then maybe we'll help someone. F it, let's do it.
We are okay.
Barely. They're alive, Eric. And Josh, the father and son we met at the camp. I didn't think anyone from the camp survived what happened near the train wreck, except for me and Cameron. But I was out scavenging and I saw them. Josh waved and smiled when he saw me. Eric looks even more on edge than he did at camp. Who can blame him? Every day you keep your child alive in this world, you're defying the odds. Josh wrote me a note asking if Cameron and I were still heading for the harbor. I said eventually, but that was a lie. I've been terrified to move Cameron. Eric looked at his son for a long moment, then wrote that Cameron and I could travel with them to the harbor. And I understood why. It's not enough to keep your child alive in this world. They need to have a friend, to have a life. I want my son to have hope. If you find this, you're welcome to the supplies we've left. I hope you pass the same kindness along to others. There's already enough selfishness in this cruel world, Kat. Calm your butt down. Better calm your butt down. Breathe. Breathe, Shotty, breathe. Breathe, Shotty, breathe.
Storm isn't gone.
I wanna eat the booty like groceries. Oh, oh.
Oh, I know what comes next.
Why? Two weeks, the A's been gone for 2 weeks. That's not coming back. There's no way. Did he lie to me? Did he know he wasn't coming back? Just didn't want to admit it? I believe it. The man loved making plans, but got bored when it came to actually doing the work. And who was always left to pick up the slack? Me. It happened with softball. It's the same dang thing that's happening at the end of the world. Some people never change, or maybe he was coming back, but something happened. Did one of those things get him? I don't know. I'll never know. If I should mourn him or hate him. Crazy. Devin, so there's been a complication in pump rooms A and B. If I close the pumps, it sets off a large water burst. At this point, I'm not sure what to do about it. Not close the pumps, I guess. Yo, I didn't know what to do. Like, he kept coming back.
No!
I didn't know what to do, bro. Like, he just kept coming back. Like, it was nowhere for me to go. He was just right there. How did he knock me back up there? He knocked me so hard that I landed right back up the... What's about to happen?
Oh, okay. Boy, I thought we was about to get snatched. Oh, I got scared. Jesus.
I don't know why I just used my flare. Dot is dot. That would have been insane if I would have died right there. Freaking father's dead. There's a lot going on, man. Pregnant. Trying to feel it.
This is an understatement, nigga. Like, I don't think y'all understand. Like, this girl can't breathe. I don't get it. Breathe, bitch, breathe!
Whatever, bro. Y'all cheating me. I could have died right there.
He's literally cheating. I don't care what nobody, he's cheating, bro.
Boy, what the hell I swear this man just be wanting to die. I swear, he be making dumb decisions after dumb decision after dumb decision after dumb freaking decision.
Private high school, do not ask me how, do not ask me why, but for some ungodly reason, the warehouse is the only remaining power source on this block. Want the lights in the hardware store? Go to the warehouse. Hoping to turn the refrigerators on 24/7, go to the warehouse. Wishing you can get into the tech store, but apparently their stupid doors won't even work without electricity. You guessed it. I've hooked up a cable to run from the tech store to the warehouse. If the power goes out again, you'll need to go to the warehouse to flip the switch, but hopefully that should do it. Corporal Harrison. We did all that out of order. P.S. Joking aside, do not divert any power to the 24/7. Nobody should have to see what's inside. On this this has just been pretty crazy, not gonna lie to you. Oh man, my name is Elijah Mike. I'm logging off, man. Until next time, peace. We will be just